All right, so we're going to go ahead and get started. Can everybody hear me okay? Is it too loud? All right, perfect. So we're going to be going over the GIS analyst tools this hour. This is going to be for the ArcMap toolbars that we have in Lucity. Just out of curiosity for show fans, how many people in here are like GIS administrators or Lucity administrators? Okay, so good number of you. The other half of you would be like end users, yeah? All right. And how many people in here have used the toolbar before? All right, awesome. A lot of what we're gonna be going over are most likely things you might already know. We're just gonna be doing a general overview of the analyst tools. They have not changed, and they're probably not going to change in the future as Esri is putting more of their innovation into the ArcGIS Pro tools. Right, Greg? All right. So my name is Maggie Ahrensberg. I've been with Lucity for almost 2 years now. I work as a support specialist. I'm here with Mike.
All right, my name is Mike Chambosky. I've been here with Lucity for about 5 years now, and I'm on the technical team for Lucity. So.
All right. So one of the first things I want to start off with is how you get these toolbars. So these toolbars are installed with ArcGIS, or no, are installed with Lucity Desktop. So if you have Lucity Desktop installed on your machine, these toolbars will then be available. They will only work with data that is linked to Lucity. So within the admin tool under GIS, in your connection strings, which is already open, you have a connection to a geodatabase. This is what Lucity is going to use with these tools, or these tools are really going to work with those feature classes in that geodatabase. And that feature class configuration is done in ArcCatalog in the geodatabase configuration tool. You can see your geodatabase connection properties here. And then all of your different feature classes that are linked are here. So getting into that a little bit more, let's take a look at a couple of features. So I have my park pools and my parks. So this is the analyst toolbar. If I select the first tool, this is the Lucity Relates tool. You can see different Lucity records that are related to the features in the map with this tool. So if I right click on this park feature, you then have this toolbar that appears. So you can see that this park, you can see its different feature relationships. With this here, you can create a request, you can create a work order, you can create a PM or template, you can create an inspection, you can view different documents for that feature in the map, or you can associate a new document. Now, this is for a feature that is linked to Lucity. If I try using this tool on my pool, oh, it's going to work. And so because my pool is linked. If my pool was not linked, you would see just an empty box here, and that would be an issue with your configuration if you're not seeing these tools have anything right here. All right, so the next tool we're going to talk about on the toolbar is the filter viewer. So the filter viewer will allow you to view a filter set of assets that you have saved. So if I select this, I get this dialog here. I'll make it, well, it didn't really help, did it? So you get this dialog here, And you can choose what module you're going to show the filter from. So if I select down here, I have the option to choose an asset inventory filter, inspection, request, work order, or template. So I'm going to choose the asset inventory option. And now in the asset type dropdown, I have options from the different feature classes that I have linked to Lucity in my map. So you can see I have some sewer feature classes in here. I have parks in here, so that's why it's giving me these options for those. So I'm going to go ahead and choose my sanitary pipes. There we are. And I have a list of filters. So these are filters that are created in Lucity. So if you create a filter in Lucity Web, like using the filter builder, and you save it, it will then be available here. So I'll go ahead and show what that looks like. I'll load the middle basin filter that I have. So this will just show those pipes that are marked from middle basin. Yes. So it's across all of them, but you can choose you can lower the filters down to be just yours in that dialog. And that would be done if I select this here. There's this checkbox that says my filters only. So if that's checked, it'll only show the filters that you've created. I haven't actually created any filters for this module. So all of these would be shared throughout the system, the Lucity system. Yeah. All right. So I've loaded up my filter for the middle basin pipes. Now, a filter is going to be more of a fluid set of assets, right? As opposed to like a subset, which we'll get into next. So if I had a pipe in Lucity and it changed locations, this filter would then no longer contain that pipe. But the subset manager, this will show a group of assets that you've created in Lucity for that module. And this would be a static list that would not change depending on values. So let's go ahead and load one of these subsets in. So once again, this dropdown is for the different feature classes that are linked in my map. So let's go ahead and choose pipes. I have two different subsets here. So I'm going to load these options here. So you can either load, you can create one, you can remove from existing, you can add to existing. I'm going to load one. So I'll go ahead and load this one. And there's my subset. All right. The next tool on this toolbar is the work frequency tool. You can see your work frequency with this tool. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. All right. So this is going to run on the selected features that I have in my map. I'm going to go ahead and use a filter. So this is from the work order module. And I'm going to choose work orders. And there weren't any in this selected set, but if I run it against the whole thing, it'll take a few minutes. So I'm not going to do that. But that kind of gives you an idea on what that tool does. Does anybody have any questions on that tool? Yes. It's going to show the work on the actual features, as opposed to like a live layers is just going to show you. Yeah, I wish I.
Yeah.
If you see in the polygon features on the left hand side on the layer of contents, it shows like the different sort of symbology that's going to like show how many work orders are on the asset. So it's basically just to determine a numerical amount of work that has been done on like a height or specific asset. Whereas the live layer will just show you the actual work order spatially. So it's just basically so you can like look at all your assets in the map and say like, wow, we've done 100 work orders on this one room. What's up with that room? And so it's just basically a numerical count.
I can try do this one. I don't think it'll take too
long. Yeah.
Yes.
It just symbolizes that asset data, that like qualification.
It can take a while to run.
I believe all these are generated on the fly as a GIS view, table view in your Lucity database. And then we just join it with the available assets that are in the map.
Yeah.
Is that correct, Greg? right click that work frequency and zoom to it. So I think it's actually working on the
okay.
Right side.
Like zoom to this?
Yeah, just like zoom to the middle way, there you go. So yeah.
So there are, yeah, okay.
So yeah, it'll symbolize the amount of work done based on that work order filter. So basically, there's a bunch of points and lines that only have like one work order on them. There's one park, I guess, that has, it's green. I don't really know what the green content is on that one. But yeah, and then there's a couple of red dots that have at least two work orders on them, or greater than two. And you can, I believe, change these in the symbology once the layers have been generated. So if you want to see like work orders or layers that have more than like three work orders, you can add tiers to that. And it's basically simple symbology editing category classification. So, but yeah, this is just the default style, but you can change how you want it to look after that once it's generated.
All right, so we're going to move on to some of these tools for different views. So all of these are views. You can view your data in different ways. The first one here is the live work layers tool. So that will show you your different live work orders or requests that are updated from the system. They're live, so they're going to be changing as work orders and requests are completed, closed, created, etc. So if I go ahead, well, I'm going to run it on requests. Okay. We are going to, let's run it on open requests. All right, I have some requests out in no man's land. but this is a live view of all of the requests. This is a really cool tool in the fact that you can actually publish this layer as a service and then put that service in like the web map. So you can have a live view of the different requests in the web map. We do have the module data spatial tool, which does a similar functionality to that, but this is a cool way to do that in the web map, and you could also load it into the mobile map. It would be live.
Yes. And so one thing about the live layers is that they use Lucity Spatial to like constantly be feeding in that information. So if we did this as just the request layer and not live, that just right when we do that builds the view in the database and then joins into the attribute data. Mm-hmm. If we do the live one, that is loosely spatial processing the spatial information of those requests, storing it, then we grab that and then build it. So,
yeah. The location?
I believe that's the category of the requests.
Yes, this is the category code right here. We have lots of categories, so that will be different depending on your system. Yeah.
For the live one,
it needs Lucity Spatial.
So you would basically, there's a system saying that says enable Lucity Spatial, you would turn that on. And then basically for all your historic work orders, requests, whatever, you can go into Lucity Web and just without any filter on, you can open up your request table and there's a button that says process spatial information. So Lucity Spatial will go check all those work orders and requests with all the spatial information and then index it in our spatial tables. And then you can pull it on the fly. So usually got to do that just to get things rolling. But at that point, once the spatial is enabled, all the new work information will be processed. So you just have to get that backlog. By default, it'll only go back to a year worth of data. So you can try and run that like 10 years worth of work orders, but it's only going to do the last year. You're like, if you're going to try and get all your work orders, you have to like set that to be like 1,000 days or something like that. So.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so this ran against my request module, and I had a preset filter. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up again. So you can see this option here, I'm selecting an existing filter, and then I have these filters that are within that request module that you've created. Yeah. So that means you could have a filter for open requests or closed requests. If you had a live view, you could then symbolize those, which could be really helpful for if you're, publishing that out, having it in the mobile, they could see the locations and see which ones were open or closed, depending on the symbology set there.
And yeah, so this is creating a new layer based off of either assets on work orders or requests, the XYs that are possibly on there, or they'll reverse geocode the addresses on there and put them as points. So, these are not connected to them. They're just symbolizing assets that are on the work orders. So, yeah.
All right. Any more questions on that? All right. I do want to say, so this can be done with requests, work orders, PM templates, and master projects and projects. Those are all the different dynamic layers that you can do. Okay. So this is for your different request locations. This is for your different work order locations, your different master projects, and your different live other ones. So I believe these are essentially the same options as what are in here, just a quicker way to get to them. So we've already seen kind of what those can do, just kind of a shortcut for you there. All right, next we have the Lucity views. So you can do these for sewer, storm, street, and water. This does not change depending on what is in your map, but the different options will be enabled depending on what is in your map. Well, it'll work. So I do have sewer data, so I'm gonna go ahead and remove this and turn on my sanitary pipes here. Let me zoom in. I have some stents set. Okay. And we then have a list of all these views. I won't go into I won't run every single one, but I'll run one of them. So let's say we want to see sewer TV inspection summary. Well, do you think this will load?
One way to find out.
Okay, so this might take a little bit, but we'll load it anyway. So I again have some filter options here. So I can do this for middle basin. We can see the syntax of that filter here. And it did not like that. So we're gonna cancel. Ooh, okay. So, oh no. Yep. All right. Try a different one. So I'm going to have to, I would have to recreate my views. This is a known issue, so hopefully you don't run into this. If you are, come talk to support. We can actually get that fixed for you. So, yes. Okay. So I think that currently mine are broken, so we'll move on. If you have questions on this, feel free to come up and ask either Mike, myself, or Greg. Greg is a great resource for this, actually. And we can answer any questions for that. Like I said, if you are seeing that, let us know at support and we can get that fixed for you.
And
yes.
Yeah, it's the views in there right now. Her logged in user doesn't have the ability to build that database view. So, it's like in the database, it's a database permission. We see a bunch, and we have a big old SQL script statement that can just build them automatically. And then it goes in. So,
yeah,
it was a bug in a previous version. And if you run into that, I think it started coming around in 17R2. Well, usually that's when I'm there. Once it's like that script's run and the craft is able to rebuild them, the issue stops at that point. So,
yeah. Yep.
Also, one thing about these views is most of these, if not all of them, are going to be in the Lucity spatial module view in the web. So these are almost one for one or will at some point be one for one. I think right now there's some of the pavement modeling that isn't in the web. So like right now you can only visualize pavement modeling results in ArcMap, but the goal is, I believe, these Lucid views of ArcMap to be able to be generated on the fly in the web map and mobile. So that's
yes.
The goal at least.
All right, so we'll move on to the next tool. Sorry about that. And this is the Lucity profile, viewer. So this will allow you to see a section of a sewer or storm system from the side. It's calculated based on the rim elevation, structure depth, upstream and downstream invert fields from the sewer structure, sewer pipe, storm structure, and storm conduit modules. So we'll go ahead and run this. I'm going to select my pipe segments. So we'll do 5 here. And it gives me this really cool 3D view of all of my different pipes. I can control what layers are in here. So I can see ground elevation, pipe, structure, lateral. I can control the labels. This has a lot of data in it. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off some of those to clean it up a little bit. I can make it 3D. Wow. And then I can print and save this for future reference. Kind of a cool tool. Does anybody have any questions on that? For manholes? I don't believe so. I don't think we can see that. It's just the side view with the depth.
Right, Greg, there's no way to do it, like.
Yeah.
Basically, all that's happening is just saying, like, the elevation of this structure is at this point relative to the pipe. So if it's just a type of a manhole, like, and it, if we have that elevation data on the manhole, we should be able to generate this. We just know, I believe it should work. It's going to display like this, but I believe we should work with a type of manhole.
I don't think we discriminate on the type of manhole.
Yeah.
It just,
yeah.
Like the line it, is loose, but
yeah, it.
It's like a connective line, so that's why we like follow it down the manhole. But yeah,
it is, and it isn't. You can rotate it. But that kind of gets a little messy and weird, so. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
your motivation. Mm-hmm. All right. Next is the TV. Observations tool. So your TV observation can be displayed in ArcMap. The tool will find the most recent inspections for a set of pipes and creates a shapefile of all the observations for those inspections. A shapefile of all the observations, each point displays the type, severity, and location of the observation. Each observation also includes a hyperlink to related images. The hyperlink information can be accessed with the Esri hyperlink tool. So we'll go ahead and run that. We'll select TV inspections. I'm going to run it on a filter. Run it on our middle basin again. I think that looks all good. All right. And here we go. So you can see you have your ratings over here symbolized by these little diamond shapes on each pipe. So I'll go ahead and zoom in on these pipes here. This looks like a good little section. And you can see those. I believe you can change the symbology if it's not clear. Yeah, you can see some of these in here. Yeah, let me see if I can.
Question. I don't know, because this is basically just plotting the points of where an observation was noted along the line. And those observation records in Lucy do have pictures or often videos of that, but yes, you can. So, but
yeah, so if you use the relates tool on this, so you can see that. If you use the relates tool, you can see your documents with this. So if I click on TV observations, double click to view.
With our data.
Yeah. Our demo
we
data?
Bought it from
we don't,
another organization,
yeah, we don't
so
have.
I don't think we actually have the pictures, but essentially if you knew there was something there, you could use that tool. See the documents and it would show all the associated assets to that, which would be a TV inspection. So
yeah.
You can see that. You can publish it out. I don't believe it'll be live updating. That's a static thing. So you could do it for like a year's worth of inspections and then push that out and you'd have that. But yeah, it wouldn't be generating every time you push data.
So when you run this tool, you can set the date for the max inspection date. So every time you run it, it's going to be like you're going to set that date. It automatically is set to today. And that's kind of how you would have to refresh it.
Yep.
Yes. All right. Go ahead and remove that. The next tool is the trace tool. So this will trace your different layers. So I can choose a trace type. Upstream, downstream, you can do distance or segment. So I'm going to go ahead and do a downstream segment. I'll clear my selection and I'll go ahead and choose 10 segments. I then get this little plus icon and I can just click. And it then traces your downstream segments and selects them. So this does not create, this is different in the fact it's not creating a layer over here, is this is just selecting your existing segments.
So a little thing about these trace tools, it does not use the information in GIS. What it does is it knows the pipe you've selected, and then it goes and queries that pipe to see what the downstream structure is, and then it just kind of goes down that line for the number of segments, builds a layer or a filter set, and then highlights it. So if your Lucity data is not entirely accurate, this tool may not be giving you the results you want. So a lot of people get confused because they're like, everything snapped, why isn't it doing it? It's because that data is not properly accurate on Lucity. So
if you have pipes that are not in Lucity, but they are in GIS, it will skip over those pipes. Mm-hmm. So you'll end up with a trace that is not complete. It'll just kind of skip different segments that are not in Lucity. So that's kind of some functionality to consider. It also works slightly differently than the trace tool in the web map. So if you're going to use one of these tools, use one or the other. I wouldn't switch between them because the logic is just slightly different in the back end.
The web map can do more with the trace.
And the web map, yes, the web map can also do more with the trace. It's a lot more, it's a little more useful. Mm-hmm. You can do isolation valve traces in the web map, things like that. All right, we're going to move on. We're going to go over the customer search. So this will search customer records, address records, and work requests to help locate them in the map. This search can be based on a customer name, address, or phone number. So if I run this tool, I get this dialog here. You have, you know, first name, last name, phone, address. So I'm actually going to just search in the last name. We'll look for Smith, and that's all I'm going to get it. So I'm going to run a search, and I then get this list here. So I can select, you know, Donna Smith here. That is her address, and then you can actually create a request right here. So I can fill out the category. We'll say she has something wrong with her sewer. There's an accident. And then I can submit and view in the desktop, in the web, or just submit it and know that it'll be there. So I'll go ahead and just submit it. All right. And then that request is created. All right. We can also do a search using the find. You can do this You can run it based on the asset ID. So if I choose parks and I know an ID here, I can do that. I believe they're just numbered, so I do two. Yep. Okay, 22. So if I type in 22, it will find that park in there. Right. The last tool is just the help, and this will launch the help guide for the analyst tools. And we'll go over all that, and we'll show you all that information.